about causal interpretation of quantum mechanics. The Schrödinger equation is a condition of stability.
All models of quantum mechanics describes many observations very well, but there are heated discussions among scientists about physical interpretations. To support the currently all interpretations of quantum mechanics formalism have some contradiction with the accepted physical theory. To support this statement, let us consider two interpretations, the Copenhagen and the Causal interpretation. Under the Copenhagen interpretation, however, followers of this interpretation face logical difficulties with its the Copenhagen interpretation is the most common one. However, followers of this interpretation face logical difficulties with experiments on essential quantum effects. For example, the experiment with quantum correlated photons or with tripartition of quantization of photons. In these cases, the formal calculations lead to negative values of the joint probabilities. Therefore, supporters of Copenhagen's interpretation don't use the joint probability for the description of quantum phenomena. Thus, under this interpretation, it is invalid to make any statements about the system property prior to this measurement. However, in context of these experiments, the problem of interpretation of quantum formalism became more evident. It is necessary to assume that also some properties of reality exist before measurements only potentially. However, there is a correlation between them. For example, the realization of each photon from the correlated photon pairs. Note that in the modern optical experiments, the scale of coherence for correlated photons can reach several kilometers. In order to explain the experiments, some physicists began to talk about non-separability. Is the ability of object to instantaneously know about each other's quantum state even when separated by large distance. It is mistaken to believe that the ideas of non-separability of quantum mechanics don't contradict the theory of relativity. Note that to measure the speed of light, it is necessary to have a receiver and a transmitter that are not only separated in space, but are also autonomous in their behavior. History, the issue of incompleteness of the description of physical reality by quantum mechanics was put forward for the first time by Einstein, Podolsky, and Rosen. They proposed looking for hidden variables. Later, it became clear that the causal interpretation agrees with quantum formats only if non-local hidden variables are taken into consideration. Quantum non-locality means the possibility of action at a distance or the possibility of superluminal interaction which requires the existence of physical field. It is clear that introduction of long distance forces or a physical field which allows speeds greater than the speed of light contradict the theory of relativity. The best known theories to achieve the agreement between hidden values and social relativity is the broad De Broglie introduced two powers, a particle and accompanying stationary wave. The stationary wave, however, required a medium, the physical vacuum in which to propagate. But only vacuum having uniform energy density and pressure agrees with the theory of relativity. Nevertheless, De Broglie introduced such a medium whose existence, in their opinion, did not contradict the postulate of relativity. De Broglie called it the subquantum medium and modeled it as the tachyon's gas. Tachyons are the particles of imaginary mass having speed greater than speed of light. The idea of the tachyon particles that De Broglie found in the work of the Russian physicist Tiryansky. Vigier was the one who proved the Tiryansky theory of the tachyonic to De Broglie. Another De Broglie's assistant. Some words about Vigier here. It will be interesting maybe to this that Vigier was a French communist and he closely collaborated with the Soviet Union. He was, and this is the reason why he know the Tiryansky theory. Another Broglie's assistant, George Lachat, wrote in his memories, memoirs, that Vigier worked for a long time on the theory of the tachyonic vacuum. But he didn't publish the results of his work. Maybe he didn't find enough evidence in support of this theory. Originally, Schrödinger was, as a De Broglie, a supporter of the causal interpretation of quantum phenomena. He thought that the matter waves to be real and the particle to be an actual wave part. The expensive condensation procedure Schrödinger turned to classical mechanics. Schrödinger started his derivation with the Hamiltonian Jacobian velocity. Here is a relationship between velocity and function S. For the motion of electron and hydrogen atom, the Hamilton-Jacobian equation takes the next form. Schrödinger next introduced a function psi and substituted into equation 1. He obtains the following equation. Schrödinger next. We search for a such function psi that will give extreme value to the integral of the quadratic form. And the earlier Lagrange equation for this variation problem turns out to be the Schrödinger equation. So Schrödinger decided that you can see the Schrödinger equation, but there are many problems in this. In his derivation, many problems. However, the derivation proposed by Schrödinger was not accepted by the scientific community for the following reason. Substitution psi assumes that psi is a real function, while the Schrödinger equation had complex solution. the Schrödinger equation don't follow from the capital E equal to equation, because the set of solution on the Schrödinger equation is not a subset of solution of the capital E general equation. The physical meanings of the variation principle used in the derivation of the Schrödinger equation was not clear. This is the way the Schrödinger equation was taken as a postulate. In the same year, Born proposed the probabilistic interpretation of wave function. Next. Even Mendelssohn and later Born corrected the Schrödinger's mistakes. They represent psi in complex form. It is easy to show that if we require that the complex function psi is single valued, then by using this substitution, we extract from all the solution of the general equation only those for which the orbital angular momentum is not desired. Born was proponent of causal interpretation of quantum formalism. Born substitute psi in such form into the Hamiltonian general equation, separated real and imaginary parts, and obtained two equations. We can see that the Hamiltonian general equation contains not only classical potential, but also term. This term. Born called it the quantum potential. It's the analysis of Born's interpretation. Born assumes that quantum potential is a formal rule. The quantum potential effects don't necessarily follow with the distance. The quantum potential has a new feature of non-locality, implying of instantaneous connection between distant particles. This Born's assumption, however, is not supported by mathematical derivations. The main Born's mistakes and many of his followers was to assume that the new obtained from a solution of Schrödinger equation has the same form over the entire space. As really special that is good. Let's go back to the derivation of the equation presented by Schrödinger and to the physical meaning of the variation principle he used. As early as 1929, Chitai, the well-known expert in the theory of stability, worked in the University of Göttingen, where he became familiar with the Schrödinger's work. Chitai assumed that the variation principle used by Schrödinger extract from all the solutions of the Hamiltonian general equation only those solutions which satisfy a condition of stability. Chitai didn't arrive to exert the Schrödinger equation because he didn't introduce hidden variables like a physical field into the limitological equation. I divided the time-independent Schrödinger from the variation principle taken as a basis the same approach that Chitai but correcting his mistake. I introduced a unknown potential field in the limitological equation. Consider now the motion of a particle that is would have if small disturbing forces with energy W are present. In this case, the motion in the of a particle takes this form. You can see. Chitai suggested that the influence of disturbing forces on a trajectory packet on an arbitrary point is proportional to the density of trajectories at this point. For the packet consists of stable trajectories, its address must be minimum. This is that is we obtain the following variation problem. Functions S and A realize the extreme of this integral if they satisfy the system of two-order Lagrange equation. The first equation coincides exactly with the equation. With the equation 3 another equation coincides with the equation 3 I will return to the equation I talk about this equation it is formed from the Schrödinger equation when both satisfy substitute psi by the real imaginary part and he obtained two equations. And after such procedure, the two Lagrange equations coincides with the two equations which we can see before. This way eigenvalues that are obtained from the Schrödinger equation are the ones that are extracted from solution of the Hamilton-Jacobian equation only those solutions that satisfy the necessary conditional stability. What can be said about the unknown potential field? Potential field on the trajectory satisfies the necessary conditions for stability, and only on them is equal to quantum potential field. Only on them, not on the space. All the trajectories remains unknown. The potential depends on the form of the trajectories. Now, using the causal approach, let us analyze the Schrödinger equation for hydrogen atom. The solution for this equation has this form. The phase of the wave function is S over H, phi. Thus, for the velocity of the electron of the trajectories obtained from Schrödinger equation, we have this one. We can see the classical approach leads the following formula for velocity. So we can see that the classical approach leads for the following formula. It can be seen from this formula that only circular orbits are possible. Only circular orbits. The probabilistic approach gives more orbital shapes, as you can see below, but in the classical approach, they are eliminated and only circles remains. And in direct support of the classical approach, you can see the picture below. This picture was obtained with the ionization microscope. Now you can see here on the circular trajectories. Note that the motion of this circular trajectory satisfies not only the necessary condition of stability. Therefore, among these trajectories, there can be trajectories that are not stable. It will be shown that Born orbit are the ideal candidates for being stable. Born orbit. both orbits. Let us consider a circular orbit with a center of origin. According to the Newton's second law, we can see. Therefore, besides the unknown column, forces acting on the center of mass, there is an additional force. On the orbit, on the Born orbit, the additional force equal to zero. Thus, on the Bohr orbit, a quantum potential equals to the energy of the precession motion of electron spin. It can be seen that the form of the energy is, in fact, the river form. Then we can provide an explanation of national QPCO and alpha, namely the structures like homogeneous precession domains are observed in superfluid gradient field, where all spins of the field particles precess with the same frequency and phase. And in the superfluid vacuum, the electron's motion should create structures similar to such domains. If we assume the existence of the quantum interaction between an electron spin and a domain spin, then we only hold this is the inverse formula. Maybe it's another mental equation.
I would think that Chitayev worked in Kazan University.
Yes. No, when began the Second War, he went to the Kazan University and worked there. But before the Second War, he worked in the veterinary. Thank you. Sorry for my English.
Said, but it looks very much like what I kind of feel, which is that the condition of stability is the most important in these situations and not the dynamics. And in fact, the dynamics, in my theory, is once you include time or the clock in the system and isolate it, which is necessary, then a system can only be isolated in some sort of a stable form, which means atoms that aren't interacting must be in some kind of a stable form, and I think this is what you're talking about here in the situation. So I've got to study what you're saying more. It's always very difficult, you know.
There is no idea. Hypothesis here, except for there exists hidden variables, like a few. Only one hypothesis, no another. It is strong mathematical. Only one hypothesis, only here.
Now, the formula that Bohr, or that Bohm came up with, you know, A e to the I, how does that relate? I mean, at least in the United States, we have a lot of emphasis is made by Feynman's approach, you know, where he assumes the same thing and the way it's presented is like he discovered this. And I guess the question is, what's the difference here? Is
there all the classical approach based on the fact that the Schrödinger equation is a question for whole space, but it is a question only for the stable trajectories. Only the stable trajectories, you know, it is the main reason. Mm. It is not the same mistakes, there was the same mistakes the walls. From Schrödinger, it is not the same. The Schrödinger is the special question, but it is not a Hamiltonian question. It can be easy to.
Yes, if you substitute psi function to Schrödinger equation, we can see two and three equations.
Yes, but only. But it is not enough. It doesn't mean that it is good for whole space.
Yes,
it's just a equation for the whole space, but it is exactly for the Schrödinger equation.
Yes, from Schrödinger to classical.
Yes.
So what you're saying is that I'm just going to rephrase this because it's kind of hard to understand everything. But what you're saying is that Schrödinger came up with an equation from the Hamilton-Jacobi equation. Then later on, it was slightly modified to make the actual what we know as the Schrödinger equation. And Bohm's mistake is that he substituted into the modified Schrödinger equation, and he should, and one could, if one substituted that in the original Hamilton-Jacobi equation, one could come up with a different solution that depends on the stability of these orbits rather than on a general statement about what's valid in space altogether, right?
Yes.
Is that kind of right?
If I recall correctly, Mohm had no physical motivation for doing what he did. He just noticed that these mathematical or algebraic manipulations would lead to something that looked a little less mysterious than the original equation. There's nothing in his argumentation that supports the existence of a so-called quantum potential, other than it has to be there in order to get quantum mechanics.
After Mohm's article, everyone began to speak about the non-locality.
Yeah.
But no non-locality in his paper, no non-locality, because that equation only on the trajectories, only this on the stable trajectories, no non-locality, it's not for the space.
Doesn't the non-locality come from von Neumann's projection hypothesis? Not, in other words, von Neumann said, when we look at a beam going through a beam splitter, we see one result or the other, but we never see the combination. If you take a state which is a sum of two different states, for example, what's it called, the one that the standard one, the standard Bell state, has an up and a down in it. Now, In real life, nothing can be up and down at the same time. Mm-hmm. Whenever you look, whenever you do any kind of experiment, you get up or you get down. Von Neumann said, well, that's because beforehand it was both, but looking at it, doing a measurement, kills one and selects the other.
Talk about quantum correlation for photons, particles.
Right.
Yes. You can see that in such experiments, the length of coherence is very...
Yeah. Well, same thing.
Very, very.
He just separates
it. Yeah, computer. It means, for me, it means
nonsense.
There is a superfluid interaction between them. Mm-hmm. But where is this interaction? In the fluid, is this vacuum, maybe it's such a superfluid, maybe another. Hypothesis, but in the vacuum, we have the superfluid interaction between the correlation photons.
But that's because he likes to believe that the quantum state with half up, half down. The singlet state.
Yes.
He wants to believe, or quantum mechanics, the quantum mechanicians all want to believe that that's an ontologically real state. Before you look, that's the way it really is. Not that's some
but
kind of representation.
You are right. But quantum physics so that this means that non-separability.
Yeah.
But non-separability contradicts the singularity. Mm. But they don't answer for this equation. Non-separability, if the receiver and the transmitter connected with non-separability, it is not good for the experiments with light and so on.
So one thing that bothers me about this presentation to some extent is if you say that the equations or the solutions have to be trajectory dependent,
yes.
Doesn't that put the solution ahead of the, I'm not sure exactly how to formulate it, but you have to know the solution in order to get the solution.
Mm-hmm.
And how does that work? I mean, that doesn't seem... I mean, if I have to know the trajectory in order to extract the solution, in order to get to then know the trajectory, it seems very circular.
Mm-hmm.
And it doesn't give me any predictive value, but it means I have to kind of know the solution in order to get the solution. Or am I missing something here? Anybody have the same problem?
The causal interpretation, there is no probability in the causal interpretation. No probability. Only, maybe statistic.
The question is,
You can ask this question because this U quantum potential depends on the A, but A is the solution of this equation. It is non-linear problem. It is non-linear problem when the solution depends on the trajectory. So it is non-linear problem. Yes, you can see such problems in hydrodynamics, non-linear problems. Yeah, yes, it's a very, very, we were lucky that the Schrödinger equation becomes a linear equation. Mm-hmm. We are lucky, it is it's good for us.
Well, the Schrödinger equation is deterministic. That's what we all say,
Right.
What you're saying is it's not a deterministic problem. It's a
non-linear problems exist, not just in quantum but everywhere. I mean, hydrodynamics, there is also solution depends on solution. It's very common. If you solve this solution, if you solve this problem from the beginning, it's a complicated integral, non-linear problem. It's just he's lucky that he's come up to this.
I can add that in the book of Bohm, quantum mechanics, he used C function without A, and he obtained only three equations. Equation 2 is a condition, continuum condition equation, and
in
Bohm is absent.
I saw the first Bohm's work, and he has this substitution in this.
Yeah.
Maybe later, I don't know.
Are you saying in some way that quantum mechanics can be classically derived as a incompressible fluid of mechanics? Is that kind of the result?
No, it's not true, because the same problem, they involve No. Все берут только уравнение Шрёдингера, никто не берет уравнение Кондиционного. А из уравнения Шрёдингера только частный случай получается, как он сказал, что частичный. А он сказал, что это же Бикенис. Но правильно не совсем. Я использую уравнение
Шрёдингера. She said it's almost correct that she used classical, you can derive Schrödinger equation from classical mechanics, but she said most of the work just take Schrödinger equation by itself and said it's valid in the whole space, but it didn't start with Hamilton-Jacobi equation, and then from there it follows that it's classically derived, but only for the stable trajectory, that it's only special case.
It's true that I divided the Schrödinger equation, but I introduce the hidden variables. Well, it is the main reason. I introduce the new term, hidden variables. But if we want to obtain the Schrödinger equation without hidden variables,
It will be like the dead end.
Well, now the hidden variable problems, I don't want to take all this time, but the hidden variable problem for me splits into two questions. First of all, if you assume that there is a particle, like an object, that has a hidden variable in it, you get one result, which has been discounted, I would say, by experiments, but the hidden variable doesn't necessarily have to be in the particle that's moving. It can be in the system that contains the particle. And is that kind of what you're saying here, that the hidden variable is in the field?
It's interesting. We may continue it later. It is a big question.
Yes. What do you think about nature, quantum potential?
Very interesting question. In my, my opinion, my derivation, it is energy of precession and energy of precession of spin in the atom
oscillation.
But I talk about hydrogen atom. Maybe only in this case I can. I can speak about it exactly, that it is a repetition of spin. It is a very strong mathematical equation.
So, any further contributions to the discussion?